This is an exploratory study.
It's breaking new ground in terms of understanding a construction technique that frankly is centuries old.
What's kind of unique is that stucco veneer has been in the market since the pyramid age. You know, I mean, sand and sculpture, okay.
The cladding lath and plaster has always been a cladding that has never had a requirement or a baseline for performance.
Stucco is an assembly, it's not a system. So we've got to get somebody to put a system together, test it, an approved system, and now sell it as a system.
It's accepted under the building code because it's been done for years and you can meet the code by doing it. Except the industry is bringing in these higher expectations.
You know, 10 years ago, even as recently as 5 or 6 years ago, the energy code, ASHRAE 90.1, was somewhat ambiguous in a requirement for continuous air barriers. It's not ambiguous anymore, you have to have one.
Stucco is gonna, I believe it's gonna have to change. We're gonna have to evolve, and so if our industry is gonna stay viable, we have to evolve with these new energy codes.
The people that are gonna be here are manufacturers, people representing the manufacturers of different kinds of components that go into walls.
The series of tests that Tremco had developed and Wiesch and Yelsner had developed was to test in phases different points of the wall assembly.
So 8 wall assemblies represent 4 different conditions with 2 different weather-resistant barriers each. Building paper, Grady building paper is one, and RxAware 230 fluid-applied air barrier is another.
Essentially, we had all of these variables, so we need to have enough walls to account for all of the variables so we can single point one layer that may be different between the two.
And then we're gonna spray the stucco lath and accessories and the weather-resistant barrier with water for an extended period because people are starting to do that in the field. There's no consensus standard on what that test should be yet.
Then you'll see the insulation attached and the lath attached over top of that. They'll test it again. And then of course the final test once all the stucco cladding has been attached onto the lath.
But hopefully at the end of the day, we'll be able to either change standards and change details and be a little more realistic about what we can expect in the real world.
And that's what these tests do as well. They really help us give a better performing wall system, a better understood wall system, a better documented wall system to the architect.
Really, my goal is to make our industry better. And I think some of the testing we do here could take us into the next decade or two, especially with the energy code.
The bottom line is nobody's looked at stucco and continuous insulation this closely before. This 9 wall assemblies is some benchmark testing.